Thank you, Quincy Access Television, for giving me this opportunity, and thank you for watching. As a graduate of Quincy Public Schools, Holy Cross College, and Boston College Law School, I know the importance of having a good education, and I have been an effective advocate for our schools. As an eight-year school committee member, in part serving as your vice chair, I led school rebuilding efforts, kept class sizes down, and improved academic and technological opportunities for all students. At a time when the city was closing schools and giving parents fewer choices, my leadership led to the construction of two new schools, Emilio Della Chiesa Early Childhood Center and the Clifford Marshall Elementary, the renovation and reopening of two schools, Beechwood Knoll and the Quincy Point Middle School, and the renovation of the Bernazzani Elementary School. Quincy's children deserve the best resources and facilities to achieve their goals. As a former prosecutor, I know about the impact of crime on families and neighborhoods. I understand the value of policing and providing the best services available. That's why, as a city councilor, in part serving as council president, I wrote and passed Quincy's Community Policing Ordinance, a proactive policing approach that focuses on areas that generate crime. I will be your voice for increased police presence in your community and for the best training and equipment for our police officers and firefighters. My commitment to fire safety has earned me the distinction of being endorsed by and named as an honorary firefighter by Quincy Firefighters. Every neighborhood should be a safe place to raise a family. My work has been notable for creating innovative ways to solve problems. I wrote and passed Quincy's hotel-motel legislation. To date, this landmark achievement has resulted in more than $15 million paid by visitors to our city to preserve and enhance our parks, playgrounds and beaches, renovate schools, boost tourism, and support historical preservation. These funds have been, will be used for Veterans Memorial Stadium, Faxon Field, Flaherty Playground, Bishop Playground, Squanto Point Ferry, LeBrec Field, Kincaid Park, and Nickerson Beach, among others. All this work without hurting taxpayers. The seniors in our community need our help. Many are house rich and cash poor. That's why I wrote and passed Quincy's Senior Workers Abatement Program, which helps seniors work off a portion of their real estate tax bills. And I raised awareness about the Circuit Breaker Law, a state-funded benefit that helps seniors stay in their homes. My work as Quincy's fiscal watchdog, seeking ways to ensure the tax dollars are spent efficiently, has earned me the endorsement of the Quincy Taxpayers Association. Reducing the tax burden on seniors and expanding programs that benefit seniors will continue to be a top priority for me as your Councilor-at-Large. I learned the importance of public works from my dad, a public works employee, and for the past 6 years, it has been my great honor to serve you as Commissioner of Public Works. During that time, I brought professionalism and innovation to the department, earning the 2016 New England Stormwater Management Award and recognition from the Department of Environmental Protection for outstanding performance. However, more needs to be done, including the replacement of 100-year-old water mains, repairing our roads and sidewalks, increasing our stormwater management programs, implementing traffic and pedestrian safety improvements, and expanding senior safety zones to ensure that seniors in high-risk areas are protected. These investments will add value to our homes and make us safer. I am committed to improving the lives of all Quincy residents. I live and work here and pride myself in being available to constituents no matter how small the problem. Using my experience, strong work ethic, and tireless advocacy for issues near and dear to my heart, I can help Quincy secure its footing while undergoing change. I am proud to be endorsed by the working families of our city, the Norfolk County Central Labor Council, AFL-CIO. On election day, November 7, I respectfully ask for your vote for Council at Large. I will be the fifth name on the ballot. Thank you.